software that's housed on your computer, I love, I actually have it on my laptop, I'll see it later.
Yes.
It operates like Office 2007 as far as the buttons and everything, but you just put it all together and then export the template.
Whoa.
It's beautiful, I love it.
It would scare me. I'd be more concerned that what was getting spit out wasn't correct.
It has its limitations.
Yeah, and obviously things like that are great for people who need to put something up quick or need to do something quickly like that. We couldn't get away with that at my job.
Right.
If you found out that we were doing that for your sites and you're paying me $10,000, you're going to be mad. You want that to done correctly, right, and in place. For example, if you put, like, every time you type code into this page, the heavier the page gets.
Mm-hmm.
You want to make this as light and as fast as you possibly can, because it will load quicker on the page. Now, Google recently rolled out this thing called Caffeine. So they modified their search engine algorithm to say, if the page loads quicker, you get better rank. So if you have two sites that are exactly the same, and they're like, okay, well, we got to pick one, they'll go with the one that loads quicker. So things like that scare me, because I know I'm good at this. I can do this real fast. And now Google's saying, hey, you guys are being rewarded. These other people, we're not gonna let that fly as much anymore. So, and that's not the only thing that the algorithm looks for, trust me, but if you have two that are equal. So that's cool and that's great, but I'm kind of scared of those types of things. So plus, I mean, like I said, if you found out that we were doing something you could figure out in a day at your house, there's no need for us anymore. So okay, so this is the index template. All this does is power what you see on this homepage front side right here, this guy. So we went in here, we edited this, we added this in here. If I refresh, it'll be gone, because remember I took it out and updated it, so it's gone. But it actually is generated from this look right here. So this is a little bit scary, but if I walk you through a couple things, I'm not going to walk you through the whole thing, but it'll kind of help to make sense as to how you get what you put into the database out on the other side. So all we're doing right here is we're saying, go look through every post that you have in the database. That's all this guy does. It starts here and it ends here. This is saying, go find every single post in the database, and we're going to look through it and do certain things for it. Do it. So I told it, I said, for this specific spot, I only want one post, and I don't want it to include anything from category 1, 106, or 123. Now, these are IDs generated by the system. You can go into the categories and hover over and say, edit ID equals 6, and that's how you know what category it is. But I just know I don't want it to include those, because she didn't want these in her main feed. That's what that means. Now, by default, it's going to give me the most recent, so I don't have to specify that. Every single one of these has a default, so that one of the defaults it has is give me the most recent. So all we're doing is looking for one post, doesn't exist in these categories, that is the most recent. So then, for that post, or for whatever, so let's say I said two here, it'd be for those posts. So this one is for that post, I want you to do all this stuff. And then you can see it's the one thing I love about theming in WordPress, if y'all ever do get this far into it, is like the call for the title is the title. So we say, where's the header? Right here. So for the post header, we want to wrap it in a header to tag, and we just want to call the title of the post. We want to link it. That's what the permalink stands for. So all we're going to do is we're going to link the title in a header to tag. That's all that's saying right there. Now, all this stuff here, that's the scary stuff. All it's doing is going into your database and saying, okay, you told me, go look through every single post in that database. Give me one of them. The one from this category, because we don't want those showing, and do this. So then when you hit save in your other, in the edit post screen, it actually spits like this. So if we look at the code here, you can see it's gone in there and just given it the link right here, and it's filled in the title. The title's not open. Put it into H2 tags. Remember, that was in the post header. So, it's easy, right? Huh?
Yeah.
Y'all ready to do this for a living?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, you say if you go inside the style sheet and edit that, it makes the page go slow?
No. So, when you put a lot of, I mean, you have to have certain code. But you want to use as minimal amount as you possibly need to. So you don't want to put a whole bunch of extra code in there just because you can. So let me see if I can give you an example. The old way of doing things, like if I wanted to style this header a certain way, I could go in here and do style, give it a margin on the bottom, 10 pixels, let's put some padding around it, let's color it a different color, like white. you know, I could do that and I could save that, and then every time the page loads, it would go through and it would take this inline style and make that happen. But if I have a bunch of these on the page, then it's going to clog it down. What I can do instead is in the style sheet, I can do all at once. Mm-hmm. So now all I'm loading it at all is this, and then that H2 tag. So instead of having that written out over and over any time on the page, we've just turned it all out, no problem. And this is one of the other beauties of content management, is that I can go in and I can make one change here to the header, save it, and it's going to change it throughout the entire site. Oh yeah, this should be your best friend. If you do anything, it should be go home and read about HTML and CSS. If you don't know about it yet. So yeah, does that help?
Yeah,
answer your question?
Yeah, I thought you were saying that, you know, if you go and edit, you know, it was...
No, editing, you're going to have to edit. Editing is fine. I'm saying some sites are heavy by default because you got to do what the client wants. If the client wants a giant image top center of your page and they want four of them to load, you're going to have to get those pictures on them somehow. Mm-hmm. The client's not happy. You can tell them all you want, hey, this is a good idea, this is a bad idea. But I just for the most part, as long as you're writing clean code and you're using as minimal as amount as possible, you'll be okay. So I don't want to scare you into not writing code. Write what you need to write. Mm-hmm. And we're talking... Google only recently rolled that out, like I want to say in the past 3 or 4 months or something like that. So it's still kind of, people are still kind of figuring out how it works, because Google's like a giant secret society and they don't want to tell anybody anything. So if you could figure that out, you'd be a millionaire because you could game the system. So.
And it's called, you said coffee?
Or caffeine.
Caffeine.
Yeah, so you can go read about it. Search engine, algorithm update, stuff like that. So. Okay, so that's kind of in a nutshell WordPress. WordPress is my favorite content management system. I love working in it. I think it's pretty simple. Oh, let me show you something else pretty cool about it. So she has these things called currently reading and this thing called obsessions. WordPress is basically powered by categories. So if we categorize something as X, we can take all of X and do things with it because we can filter by categories. You can also filter by tags, you can filter by other things. My favorite to do is categories. So if we wanted to look at like the sidebar, for example, here's that same thing. So all we're doing here is we're going through all the posts, but this time, remember, instead of cutting out the 106 category, we're adding it in, but we're only adding that one in. So because if you put category equals 106, that's all you're getting. So if you wanted more, you have to put a comma after it, say 200, 207, whatever you wanted to add. It just so happens, when you look at that, category 106 is the category for currently reading. So that's why we put everything that she's currently reading under that category. And then we can say, okay, so for every post that's categorized as currently reading, do this guy. And I won't go through that, but I will show you what it looks like on her end, because she doesn't know how to do that kind of stuff either. So she uses these things called custom fields, where she can say, for the wherever I want the book author to spit out, put this there. Wherever I want the book title to spit out, use this. And then for every time I want the thumbnail show up, all this is a link to the image. The situation, you have to change it. It just dynamically goes in and resizes it and spits it out there. However I tell it to spit out. So this is kind of hard coded in there, and this is hard coded in there. So she doesn't have to mess with any of that code. She doesn't have to touch any of it. Yes, sir.
So the things that are hard coded, those are the fields of the database.
Let me see. The things that are hard coded are the things in the database. Do you mean hard coded?
The field headings. Field headings in the database.
That all that is being spit out on the template generation side. The database doesn't actually spit out the HTML or CSS. All it is, that's a good question. All this does is hold the content. Like everything else can reside over here on kind of the front end slash back end side. So when I go in and hard code like currently reading here, for example, that doesn't actually go into the database. The information is getting pulled looks like this. like that right there. Because it has to go back and it has to find the information that she's put in and back in and save, so that we can go and take that and manipulate it and put it out. The theme itself doesn't live in that content database. Does that make sense?
I think so, yeah.
Kind of?
I know it's not in the database, yeah.
Right. Okay. So anytime you go in and you have to draw from that content well, pull stuff out of it, that's dynamic, that's when it actually goes into a database. So all that other stuff that I hard code on there, it doesn't need to go in there.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
All of a sudden, like, there's, every post has a title. Should have a title. Every post has a title. So we gotta store that somewhere, and then we can pull it out somehow. But we don't need to store the fact that the top says title. I can go and put, I mean, I don't want that. I can go and put that in there and hard code that to say title, header, whatever I need it to say, or nothing, if I just wanna spit out the actual title instead. So all that stuff is basically dynamic. That's kind of, trust me, I'm like trying to make it, dumb it down a little bit to the point where it's, let's say it's all dynamic content. Oh, come on. Don't be mean. Is there another question here?
I was lost on, you said 106. Where did you get that number?
Oh, okay, I'll show you. So we can go in and create a category. If I want to put in, I'm not going to put it in there because it's hard to get out. But if you go edit it right here, do you see this right here in the bottom?
No, I can't see it.
Category ID equals 59. That's how I know what category it is.
Oh, okay.
So you can, you don't even have to use the ID. You can go in and you can call it by its name.
Mm-hmm.
I hate doing that, especially with clients, because what clients always do is think that they want to change everything because they know better, right? The client always knows better. So they go in and they hit, well, I don't want to say 101 and 1001 anymore. I want to say 102 and 1001. You know, or something crazy like that. So they go and change it, it breaks, they call us, we're like, why did you change that? Well, I wanted to change it, okay, cool. So we'll go in and charge you to do this because you screwed it up. That's not good for anybody. What's really good is taking that ID, which never changes, and spitting that out. So I think other people disagree with me. There are some types of thought that say, you know, if you're looking at the back end and you want to know what categories you're including, it's much better to have the name there. And so you don't have to keep going back and forth looking at the IDs and wasting your time doing that. But what I've found is if you give it to a client, the client will break it. They will find a way to mess it up. It is your job. I'm not kidding. It is your job to make it as foolproof as possible. And to me, that means credit coding that number because they cannot change that. So,
quick question. Would you use that, WordPress for an entire website, a corporation website?
It depends on what you're looking to do, and yes, because a lot of corporations ask for what we call brochure websites, and brochure websites are basically, well, we don't want the homepage to change, we just want people to come and learn about our company, right? So they click, okay, here's the partners, here's how to contact us, here's our location directions, that's all we need, right? Okay, great, no problem with that whatsoever. You don't need to use Drupal or one of the proprietary software systems that my company came up with, Tendency. You don't need to use these because they're behemoths. It's overkill. And you'd be spending more money every month for something you don't really need.
What about when the end user has to input information and get information out of the website?
They can still do that. You could use WordPress to... Oh, you're talking about like if the end user, not people who are like updating?
No, actually both. What I'm thinking is where I work at, we don't have the content system management,
mm-hmm.
but we have different ways. But I'm kind of pushing it to actually get a content management system.
Good for you.
But like I said, is this a whole...
Oh, I know.
Whole
I'm in there.
To get approved.
Yeah.
For example, my company where I work at, we do polls. Our company is in Mexico. Actually, the manufacturing company is in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And our clients...